हेलो माय डियर लैटवियन फ्रेंड्स, ए वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ़ यू एंड ए वॉर्म नमस्ते, वेरी वॉर्म बॉयलिंग नमस्ते फ्रॉम इंडिया. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट ऑल द ऑर्गेनाइजर्स, रिमार्केबल ऑर्गेनाइजर्स, स्पीकर्स, रेक्टर, वाइस रेक्टर एंड ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स ऑफ LSPA फॉर इन्विजनिंग दिस रिमार्केबल कॉन्फ्रेंस ऑन द थीम ऑफ पास्ट, प्रेजेंट एंड फ्यूचर ऑफ योग ड्यूरिंग दिस एस्टोनिशिंग कमेमोरेशन ऑफ इंटरनेशनल डे ऑफ योग सेलिब्रेशन, द सेकेंड IDY celebration in the Riga. This is what I can call as the call of the hour, this theme, past, present and future. One thing that becomes absolutely pivotal in all these three dimensions, past, present and future, I'm just trying to actually set the theme for the conference, is the concept of the time, that is the central. And in the concept of the time, it again becomes crucial to remember that the time becomes bliss for those who are able to appreciate its gravity in the moments of historical transformation. I would say that the moments of bliss and opportunity knocks at our doors rarely, not every day. We think that it's coming every day, it's not like that. It comes rarely to us. On momentous occasions, on historical junctures, opportunity comes to knock at our doors. Excellence comes to greet us. And those of us, those rare people among us who are able to appreciate those moments of great prospects, their names get included in the history books. They are lauded for their remarkable efforts. Fortune favors those who are brave enough to appreciate the value of the time. And the day of today is such a piece of time when those of us who would be able to appreciate the intensity of it, the weightage of it, they, their generations would be revered for their deeds. On the look of it, nothing special is happening. It's not like a time of world wars. It's not like a time as depicted in the Indian epics like Mahabharata and Ramayana, where some demon have captured the earth and it needs to be rescued. It's not a time like that. But in today's time, the demon, the hell, the conflict, all is happening inside the mind of the mankind. We really do not have to search for another battleground now. We have created the mind of the mankind as a new battleground. All the wars are taking place. All the conflict are taking place inside us. The pain, the suffering, the sorrow, the tension, the stress, the strife that is inside the human beings was not even at the field of world wars. The man of today is living inside the big houses, earning big bucks, but have got no one to share his emotions with. They are absolutely alone, absolutely lonely. We have made huge houses for us to live in, but we have broken down the families. We have reached to the moon, but we have forgotten ourselves. We have advanced the medicine. We have got definitely the better hospitals than before, but we have compromised our health. And worst of all, we have populated the earth, but we have annihilated the humanity. Compassion is gone. Greed and decline rule the earth. And this world demands a change. If everything continues as it is, then we would be leaving a damaged world, a fractured society for the next generation. Families would be broken, individuality would be gone, and humanity would be dead. Who would like to have that? And who can change the world better than the people who are nurturing the right message of yoga in their hearts and minds? People like you who are sitting in the audience. I know the people sitting in the audience, they have got the most pure, sacred, chest, remarkable energy that one could have. And this world is not bad because of those people who are bad, but it is also bad because of the people who are good and they don't do anything about it. And people like you can change it. The future of the yoga, as I envision through this outstanding conference, is to present these kind of personalities who have got that belief in their heart that they can change the world, they can transform the world. This is the real message of the yoga. This is the future of the yoga. To define the concept of yoga, let me give you an analogy that as human beings, we have got two of the natures. One that is so mortal, perishable, attached to anything and everything, full of primal passions and desire. Another which is blissful, which is eternal, which is purely divine. And the journey of the man from this lower apparent existence to this higher supreme divine nature is the journey of a yogi. And we cannot reach to that higher being without removing, without changing our evil tendencies. And the journey of the yoga teaches us that before we change everything else, we need to change ourselves. Before we find everything else, we must find ourselves. Otherwise, the scenery around us would keep changing and we will continue to remain what we are. So I would wish all of you that this conference would allow you to return home with some sincere messages. Message about the future of yoga, message about the future of this world, message about the future of humanity, that we all can change the future by igniting the flame of yoga inside us. And the future of yoga lies in offering a journey to all of you towards your life's purpose. And for that to happen, any path is a good path as long as you do it right. There is no reason that we should believe that only one path is right. All paths are right as long as we are committed to it with determination, patience, persistence and perseverance. All paths are right. And this is what yoga teaches us, that we have to unite all of them. We have to find balance among all of them. We have to find harmony among all of them. And that is the real message of yoga. Now for the last, I know the time is limited. As the take home message, I shall quote one of my dearest friends and a great philosopher who once said to me that every act of hard work should be followed by relaxation. Simple message, but it's a great message indeed. And I would urge all of you that after these hectic hours of mental hard work, also find some time for mental relaxation. That is where the real benefit lies. So I hope that you would return home with some senior and sincere messages of the yoga, and this conference would be able to provide you something meaningful for your life. Once again, thanks to the organizers, rector, vice rector at LSPA, Sunita ji, and all the participants who have worked very hard for this conference to be successful. Many thanks to all of you. And pranam, namaste from India, from Shanti Kunj Haridwar, Dev Sanskriti Vishwavidyalaya. Dhanyavad.